Hey guys, Steph here. I'm the Secret Slob. Today I'm gonna share with you my all-time favorite cleaning products. So if you've been watching this channel for a while, you know that I like using natural products. I have three little kids, so I like them to be generally safe. Even though I keep my cleaning products up, I don't want my kids getting into them and hurting themselves. It's important that my products work to clean things without me having to work too hard. And most importantly, they have to be cheap. I'm super cheap. I refuse to pay $8 or $9 per bottle of spray cleaner. So here it is, my all-time favorite cleaning products. So the first thing I'm gonna show you is something you've probably seen me use a lot. This is my vinegar water spray. I found this vinegar cleaning spray bottle in the vinegar aisle, not the cleaning aisle, and I thought, oh, that's perfect. So I bought this, it was about $3. But I actually refill it using a giant 4 liter or 1 gallon vinegar bottle. So this, although this says Allen's Natural Lemon Scented Cleaning Vinegar on it, this is just the bottle. I keep refilling it. I use about 1/3 vinegar, 2/3 water, and I use this on glass. I use it in my bathrooms. I use it for my swish and swipe. There are so many places you can clean with vinegar. Oh, shining my sink. It's so helpful, so awesome. Save yourself a ton of money and make your own cleaning vinegar spray yourself. The second cleaning spray that I use, I also make myself, and I call it straight up soapy water. You can see I wrote soapy water on there. I pick up these spray bottles from Dollar Tree. They're like $1.25. They work really well, and this one is, I don't know, maybe 1.5 years old. Still hasn't worn out. So what I use my soapy water for is dusting, cleaning my floors, cleaning any sensitive surfaces like wood or porous surfaces. You know, it's just a gentle soapy mixture. I also like to throw a little bit of essential oils in. So this is an orange one, and that's just for the smell. I have heard it helps with cleaning abilities, but I don't know. I just like to make it smell a little bit better. So for this, I put 1 teaspoon of regular old dish soap. Some people I know swear by Blue Dawn, but hey, this is what I have, so this is what I use. And then I fill the rest up with water, and I put like 5 or 10 drops of this essential oil in. This soapy mixture works great for pretty much everything. I love having the spray bottle. I never fill up a bucket with soapy water. I just spray it wherever I need to use it and wipe it down. Works so good. My next super favorite cleaning product is baking soda. So if you haven't used baking soda to clean with yet, you've got to give it a try. This was actually a product that was recommended to me in the comments of another cleaning video. So I used to use a cleaning paste that I purchased. However, I tested making my own cleaning paste out of a little bit of baking soda, some water, and maybe a bit of soap, and it works just as well, and this is so cheap. The top of my stove gets so shiny from this. Just anywhere you need that kind of scrubbing paste. Sometimes when I have a really bad bathtub ring, this works super awesome, especially when you spray with vinegar afterwards and it all foams up and kind of goes away. It's a little bit fun too. The next thing I want to share is every day you probably know I do a swish and swipe of one of my bathrooms. That includes rinsing out my toilet. So I want to share with you my all-time favorite toilet cleaning brush, and it's this one right here. This one's still in the package. It's from IKEA. These little bad boys cost $1.50. I just buy a whole bunch of them, and when they get super gross, I toss them away. I know that's wasteful, but you know what? There are just some things in life we can't hang on to forever. At one point I did purchase like a $20 toilet brush, and it did not work as well as this little puppy. It's got nice firm bristles, and you can like get in all the spots, and then it's got its own little holding container, so you just put it right in there behind the toilet. I've had a few incidents with my kids trying to help me clean the toilet when it's full. And so I usually just toss them away and start myself a fresh one. So $1.50 IKEA, pick yourself up like 5 or 10 of these and you're good for the next year. Okay, so let's get into cloths. I know cloths are like a major point of contention for people. Everyone has their favorite brand, their favorite cloth. So right now I'm gonna share with you my secret weapon little cleaning cloth, and it's this. It's called a magic towel, and they're actually washcloths, probably for little kids. And basically they're just those little compressed washcloths, but they're from the dollar store again. So basically what you do is you put it in water and expands and it turns into, you know, a washcloth like this. So this is my Elsa washcloth, and it is a terrible washcloth. Like, it is so rough. My kids don't want to use it. But what it's really good for is cleaning, because it has like some serious abrasive power. So this is my greatest little cloth that I found. A dollar at the dollar store. Your kids will love using it in the bath the first time when it expands, and after that, you know, it's just a really good scrubby washcloth, and they come super clean. One thing I cannot stand is having washcloths that I have to wash in some special way. These are rags. I just want to throw them in the washing machine and have them come out clean. So this is so great. I totally recommend it. Go to the dollar store. Don't buy them on Amazon. They're like $8. Dollar store. Pick whatever character you want. There's a whole bin of them. So far, everything I've showed you has been very inexpensive. There's a couple things that I use that cost a little bit more money, but I swear by them. The first one is this window cleaning cloth, and it's Norwex brand. I throw this right into the wash. It comes out perfect, and I use it with my vinegar water spray on all of my mirrors and my windows. And if you're a Norwex rep, I'm sorry. I know I'm supposed to just use it with water. I don't care. I use it with my vinegar, and it works great for me. This cloth is probably over 15 years old, and I think it's like over $20, but I feel like I've gotten good use out of it. So I really do like this window cloth. If you do not have $20 for a window cloth, the next best thing is just plain old newspaper. So grab yourself some newspaper, give it a try on your windows, your mirrors. It works awesome. My other favorite cloth I got at the same Norwex party 15 years ago is this little dusting mitt, and it's super fuzzy and soft, and you put your hand right in and then you kind of dust all your surfaces. So I don't know if it's actually the cloth material that I like. It does pick up quite a bit of dust, or the fact that I get to wear it like a happy little glove that I like the best. But this is my favorite dusting cloth, and I'm always sad when I forget to wash it 1 week and I have to use a plain old cloth to dust all my surfaces. Wah, wah. So this dusting mitt and the window cloth, I think, are well worth the money. That being said, these are 15 years old. I can't even tell you how much I paid for them, so worth the money. But if you don't have $20 for a cloth, don't worry about it. You don't need these. Another product I love that's from the dollar store, I'm now realizing how much cleaning stuff I buy at the dollar store, is these little miracle eraser sheets. And you probably have heard a name similar to that. And these are from the dollar store. They work exactly the same. So no need to spend lots of money on the brand name. Just go to your dollar store. These are $1.25, and there's no chemicals. You just get them wet, and it's something about the texture of them that gets, you know, pen marks off of walls, markers off of walls. This is a huge problem in my life because I have kids. So I'm always using these to get pen and marker, stuff like that, mostly off my walls is what I'm using this for. When I'm going around doing my really quick clean of my house, I like to keep my cleaning caddy with me. Everything's in here. I've got paper towel, which I use to wipe down the bathroom sinks and toilets so I can just throw it in the garbage. Nobody wants toilet rags all over their house. I keep a pair of rubber gloves in here because sometimes, especially now, I've had to use a bleach mixture to disinfect. I have an old toothbrush that is really good for scraping little corners and stuff. Definitely retire your old toothbrushes to your cleaning caddy. Some garbage bags, and then I always keep my water vinegar mixture in here, my soapy water, and my window and mirror rag. So this is what my cleaning caddy looks like. I just love it. It's got a little handle, and it's from, you guessed it, the dollar store. So no need to spend a lot of money there either. So with all of my cleaning products, my number one priorities are safe for my children, natural, not a lot of crazy chemicals that are gonna hurt my skin or my lungs to breathe them in, and low cost. It's super important to me that I don't spend a ton of money for things that I know can work just as well. I'll include in the descriptions all of the recipes I've talked about here today. If you're gonna try any of my recipes out though, please try it in a small inconspicuous area first of your furniture or your floors or whatever you're trying it on. I don't want anybody's stuff to get ruined. This stuff's pretty safe, but hey, always best to try it out first. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you give some of these a try. There's no need to spend a ton of money on cleaning products. And let me know if you have any recipes that work awesome for you. Like I say, this cleaning paste recipe came from the comments, so always share with me. I love to hear from you. I will talk to you very soon. Bye.